Good morning, students. As you know that I have started the third chapter, Ishvan the Storyteller, from 9th standard book, Moments. And today I am going to start from the last paragraph of page 14. I was studying in the junior class at that time and watching the whole drama from the rooftop. So students, as we know that Ishvan had started to tell the story of the mad elephant, and we also know that how did the elephant reach the school playground, and there he destroyed school property. Teachers and students were watching the elephant helplessly and they couldn't do anything as the elephant had gone mad. So here Ishvan told that at the time of incident he was in junior class and watching the whole drama while standing on the rooftop. And suddenly what did he do? He took a stick from the hands of one of his teachers and ran towards the ground. And what did elephant do? The elephant looked at him red-eyed and he thumped it, means he made a loud sound while lifting its trunk. And at this moment, what did Ishvan do? He moved forward, mustered his force, and whacked, means hit its third toenail. And as a result, the elephant was stunned and started to shiver and then collapsed, means fell down to the ground. At this moment, Ishvan stopped his story unfinished, saying that he would come after warming up the dinner. So when he came back, he concluded his story saying that a veterinary doctor was summoned, means called, to revive the animal. To revive means to give energy or strength to the animal, and after 2 days it was taken to the jungle by its mouth. Well, how did you manage to do it, Ishvan? How did you bring down the beast? It has something to do with a Japanese art, I think so, karate or jujitsu it is called. So here Ishvan told that with the help of or by performing karate or jujitsu, he managed to control the mad elephant. Not a day passed without Ishvan recounting some story packed with adventure, horror and suspense. Means here Ishvan every day would tell the story that was horrible and full of suspense or adventure. And Mahindra would also listen his story because his way of telling the story was inimitable. Inimitable means unique. And he would enjoy the story whether it was credible, means whether it was believable or not. One morning, when Mahindra was having breakfast, Ishvan asked, "Can I make something special for dinner tonight, sir? After all, today is an auspicious day." Auspicious means good day. "According to tradition, we prepare various delicacies," means tasty food, "to feed the spirits of our ancestors today, sir." So what happened? One morning, Ishvan, after having breakfast, asked Mahindra if he could prepare a special meal or tasty food for dinner, as it was a good day and it was a tradition to prepare tasty food to feed the souls of their ancestors. So that night Mahindra enjoyed the tasty food and complimented, means praised Ishvan for his culinary skills, means for his cooking skills. And hearing his praise, Ishvan was very happy and again he started to tell the stories of spirits or ghosts. Supernatural means spirits or ghosts, or related to spirits or ghosts. "You know, sir, this entire factory area we are occupying was once a burial ground." So what did he tell? He told that the factory area where they were living was once a burial ground. Means dead bodies were buried there. So he also told that he had seen skulls or bones there. So here, after this, He went on to narrate how he sometimes saw ghosts at night. So he had seen ghosts at night. Especially he talked about the horrible ghost of a woman which appeared off and on, means sometimes, not frequently, at midnight during the full moon. And it was an ugly ghost having matted hair, means untidy hair, and shriveled face, means wrinkled face. And the ghost looked like a skeleton holding a fetus in its arms. Fetus means unborn child. Mahindra shivered at the description and interrupted, means stopped him, saying that he had gone mad. And what did he do? He left the room and retired, means went to sleep. And he expected that at least for a few days he would be silent. Silk means silent.